This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 4-4 in your book on page 204. The target is I can identify proportional and non-proportional relationships by finding a constant rate of change. Let's look at the example in the book here to get us prepared for constant rate of change. It says Vanita can download 2 songs from the internet each minute. This is shown in the table and in the graph. So you can see where zero times she has 0 songs. At 1 minute, she has 2 songs downloaded. 2 minutes, 4 songs. And you can see they're plotting those points as they go along here. It says, pick several pairs of points and find the rate of change between them. What is true of these rates? Well, let's take a look at the first 2 points. We'll take the blue and the green right here, these 2 first ones. And if you look, you got a line in between them, and that would be, it looks like it's 1 minute, you get 2 songs. But look at the next, if you take that next blue one up there, from here to here, that's another minute going over to the right, and then 2 minutes going up, if you look at it on the side here. So it looks like it's the same. It's always going to be the same. So what is true of these rates? They're the same, or what we like to call constant. It says relationships that have straight line graphs, as you can see up here, like the one in the example, are called linear relationships. Notice that the time in minutes increased by 1, the number of songs increased by 2 each time. And if you look at it in a table of points, here's what it would look like. Notice it's going up by 2 on the top each time here. And then on the bottom, of course, it's going up by 1. And the rate of change would be the 2 over the 1, which is 2 songs per minute. Keep in mind, the rate of change between any 2 points in a linear relationship is the same or constant. So anytime you see a linear relationship, you know that the rate of change is constant. And that's what they call it. A linear relationship has a constant rate of change. Let's look at example 1 here. It says the balance in an account after several transactions is shown. Is the relationship between the balance and the number of transactions linear? If so, find the constant rate of change. If not, explain your reasoning. All right. Well, let's take a look. It says the number of transactions, 3, and then that goes to 170. 6, it goes to 140. 9 is 110. 12 is to 80. Well, I notice in between each one of these, and hopefully you can see this, it looks like it's going up by 3 each time. Adding 3 each time. What's happening over here? It's actually going down by 30, isn't it? Going down by 30. I'm just noticing that as I look at this chart. That's going to help us here. So take a look. There's our chart again. And then we're going down by 30. As the number of transactions increase by 3, the balance in the account decreases by $30. What does that mean? Well, since the rate of change is constant, meaning notice it goes the same amount each time as the same amount each time over here, says the constant rate of change is negative 30 over 3, or negative $10 per transaction. So when you divide the negative 30 and divide by 3, you get negative 10. This means that on average, each transaction involves a $10 withdrawal. How do you give a shot on this? You do A and B, come back and check it out. See how I do it. Here's what it says. Determine whether the relationship between the 2 quantities described in each table is linear. If so, find the constant rate of change. If not, explain your reason. All right, I'll take a look. If it's already a table made, we can draw the graph. I don't have graph paper. So the way we do it is, let's take a look at what's happening in between these here. This is going up by a constant amount of 5. Hopefully you can see that. You don't need a calculator for that information. And then on the right side here, it's going down by 5 here. And then it's going down, it's only going down 4 here. Then it goes down 4 here again. Notice that these numbers are not always the same. It went down five. When it went up five here, it went down five. When it went up five again, it went down four. So that's not constant. That means it's changed. So what we would say is this is not a constant rate of change. And therefore, it's not linear either. Excuse me, not linear. There is no constant rate of change because it's different. Let's take a look at B. In this case, we've got it's going from 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8. Those are going up by 2. And what's happening here? $8.50 to $17. That's going up by $8.50, actually. $8.50 and $8.50 make $17. 17 plus $8.50 is actually $25.50. So it went up by $8.50 again. And then from $25.50 to $34, well, look at that. That's $8.50 again. There you go. Now, you can see this is going to be a linear relationship because the rate of change is the same for each one. So I would call this linear because it does have a constant rate of change. But now we have to find out what the constant rate of change is. We'll call it the constant rate of change, CRC. What is that? The constant rate of change is going to be your, what we call our x variable and y variable. We're going to take our 850. Put that on top. One other thing you'd like to remember is dollars typically go on top. So it's going to be take your dollars, 850, and put it over the rate of change on the bottom, which would be the x value. So 850 divided by our 2. And what does that come out to be? When you cut that in half, that's going to be $4.25 per roll. We're talking about wrapping paper here. So there is our constant rate of change. Right, let's look at example two. It says find a constant rate of change. Find the constant rate of change for the cost of each personal pizza ordered. Interpret its meaning. Well, first things we have to do are find two points on the graph. So choose any two points on the line and find the rate of change between them. In this case, we're going to use 1, 3. You can see that's this one right here. And then we're going to use 3, 9, and that's this one right here. They could have chose that other one in the middle there, but they didn't. Doesn't matter which one. And what do we have? We got one pizza costs $3, three pizzas cost $9. All right. So how do we find the constant rate of change? We're going to take the change in the cost and divide by the change in the number of pizzas. Notice what they've done. They've taken $9 minus the $3 and 3 minus the 1. That's equating to this right here. 9 minus 3 and 3 minus 1. You might even notice that your y values are on top and your x values are on bottom. When you do that, you get 6 over 2. That reduces to 3 over 1, which is $3 over one pizza, which means, of course, you are getting what? $3 for every one pizza ordered. How about you check it out? See if you can do one on your own. Come on back, check with me. Here it is. Find the constant rate of change for the time it takes to complete a highway trash pickup project for each number of volunteers in the graph shown. Interpret its meaning. We'll take a look here. We've got trash pickup project. I've highlighted a couple points, the red and the green. So we need the two, we need these coordinates of these two points. So let's take this point right here and we'll find the coordinates of it. What are the coordinates of that red point there? Well, here's our x value, and here is our y value. Our y value is going to be over here. We don't know what it is. We're going to have to estimate that. So we've got x value of 8, and then a y value of, oh gosh, let's see here. So we're going up here, and then we come across here. And what do we have? We have 60, so then this line right here is going to be 70. This is 70. So what is that? That's about 75, isn't it? Right there in the middle. So we'll put 75. So we got 8. Which is the volunteers. 8 volunteers takes us about 75 minutes to do the trash pickup. What about the green one? All right, let's find that one. Let's put those points down. Get the coordinates. All right, so we have 16 for our x value. And what do we have for our y value? Well, we'll go straight across. That's 60. That was an easy one. All right, now how do we find that constant rate of change? Since this is linear, as you can see, what do we do here? We're going to take our 60 and subtract our 75. Take our 60 and subtract our 75. And then we're going to take our 16 and we're going to subtract our 8. So on top we have the volunteers. We're subtracting the volunteers. And then on the bottom, we're actually taking and doing our time. All right, when we do that, 60 minus 75 is negative 15. 16 minus 8 is 8. So we would say, if you do this math correctly here, that's going to be negative 8 and 7/8 minutes per volunteer. Almost negative 9 minutes per volunteer, which means you save 9 minutes, roughly 9 minutes per volunteer that you have. Now, when you do this math, you notice that I'm taking this, the green dot, and I'm subtracting off the red dot when it comes down to these numbers down here. That gets a little confusing, but I notice that this graph goes down, and we're going to take those y's on top. I mean, these are our y's, and we're going to take our x's and put those on bottom. That's how that works. All right, let's look at example three. Identify proportional relationships. Use the graph. Oh, I'm sorry. At the top here, it says some linear relationships are also proportional. We talked about proportionality in our two previous lessons. It says use the graph to determine if there is a proportional or linear relationship between a temperature on the Fahrenheit scale and a temperature on the Celsius scale. Now, we did this example in one of our problems we did in class with the Celsius and Fahrenheit. And this is actually a reverse of that problem. So you can see where they've given us the Celsius and the Fahrenheit on this graph. You notice that at 0 degrees Celsius, that's 32 degrees Fahrenheit. At 9 degrees Celsius, that's 37 degrees Fahrenheit, and so on and so forth. And it's linear, meaning it creates a line. Well, we have to determine if it's proportional. You might think, oh, that's proportional, but you can't just look at the graph like this and say yes or no unless you know some simple information, which I'll show you later. Here it says, since the graph of the data forms a line, the relationship between the two scales is linear. This can also be seen in the table of values created using the points on the graph. And that's what they've done down here for you. So you notice they've taken the 0 and the 32, put it into this little chart where they have Fahrenheit on top, Celsius on bottom. And now they're taking and showing you that, yep, notice it goes up 5 for every Fahrenheit, and then 9 on the bottom for every Celsius. It's constant there. So the constant rate of change would be, if your change in Fahrenheit to change in Celsius, that's the way they're stating it, would be 5 over 9. If it was the change in Celsius to change in Fahrenheit, then we'd have 9 over 5, 9/5. That was in the example in the book. So in this case, we're doing Fahrenheit to Celsius, therefore it's 529, or 5/9. That's the constant rate of change. So it says, to determine if two scales are proportional. So we figured out that we have a constant rate of change, which means it's linear. We got to figure out if it is proportional. To determine if the two scales are proportional, express the relationship between the degrees for several columns as a ratio. Now, this is what we did in class previously. Now, I'm going to erase some stuff up here, some of this material here, and I'm going to show you what we've done in the past. We've actually taken these. We can't use this first one just because it has a zero in it, but we're going to use the other relationships, and we're going to create our ratios. Notice that 37 over 9, 42 over 18, 47 over 27, and 52 over 36. And if you look at what those are equal to when you divide the top by the bottom, you notice they're not all the same. And you remember, when they're not all the same, what do we call it? That's right, non-proportional. Since the ratios are not all the same, a temperature in degrees Celsius is not proportional to the same temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, which you figured out two lessons ago when you did that example. It was example 8 in the home or the classroom work. All right, how about this one? Check your progress is the last one we'll do. It says use the graph to determine if there is a proportional linear relationship between the weight of an object measured in pounds and the mass of the same object measured in kilograms. Explain your reasoning. All right, take a look here. We've got a couple of points. We're saying 20 pounds is the same as 9 kilograms, and then 40 pounds is the same as 18 kilograms. So I'm going to take these two. Oh, and then there's also the others. I'm going to build my chart over here. Got 4 points for us. And we'll do, let's say they're measured in kilograms. So we'll say pounds to kilograms. Just the way they stated in the example up here. They give us pounds and they give us kilograms. So we've got, let's see here, 20 pounds equals 9 kilograms. And we got 40 pounds equals 18 kilograms. We got 60 pounds, that's 27 kilograms. And 80 pounds, 36 kilograms. All right, now I can see here that it is going up by 20. So these are all plus 20 up here. And down here, it's going up a constant 9. Every one of them. So we would say it definitely has a constant rate of change, and that constant rate of change would be 20 over 9. And we can divide that out. That's going to be about 2 2/9. What that means is it's 2 2/9 pounds per 1 kilogram. That's roughly 2.2. Now, is that a proportional relationship? That's when we do this in red, look at these relationships. So is 20 ninths the same as 40 eighteenths? And is that the same as 60 27ths? And is that the same as 80 36ths? Well, yes it is. Every one of those is equal to the same value. You can actually reduce this down if you divide by 2 here. You'll see, you'll reduce it down to 29. And that's what it all comes out to be, 29, or the 2 2/9. So because these are all equal, they are called, or this is called a proportional relationship. And it's not only just a proportional relationship, it's a proportional linear relationship. You know when there's a proportional linear relationship in general? It says the two quantities A and B have a proportional linear relationship if they have a constant ratio and a constant rate of change. So the constant ratio comes from here, and that's going to be our 2 2/9. And it's also known as our constant rate of change. There should be a fraction bar down there. All right, you want the simple teacher trick? If you've lasted this long, we're about 19 minutes in. Here's the teacher trick to determine if something is proportional. Do you notice that this line goes right through our 0, 0, our origin? If the line goes through the origin, then we have a proportional relationship. Real easy, eh? Well, take a look at this one up here. Was this a proportional relationship? No, it wasn't. Notice it doesn't go through the origin. Therefore, this one was a non-proportional relationship. I believe that's what we said down here. Remember? Not proportional or non-proportional. Again, goes through the 0, 0, proportional. If it doesn't, then we don't have proportionality. Don't forget, you can always watch this over again or read the examples in the book, which these are the examples in the book. Or you can go online and check out the personal tutor videos. And as usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.